Hello everyone, Adam here, and today a hardcore hacking episode in which I'll be cloning my garage key, which you can see here. It is shown in many of my videos, so this one that operates on frequency 433.19 something, and I will be doing a cloning with my device, which was originally a radio jammer that is composed of two parts. I mean, first is a Digispark Arduino device based on ATtiny85, and the second that is connected to it is a radio transmitter basically named FS1000A, which basically does a simple ASK modulation. And the first device that you need is a RTLSDR dongle, because first I will have to record the transmission from the key on the PC and then try to compose the same signal on an Arduino device that will steer the transmitter. And in a minute I will show you how to do it, so be prepared. Okay guys, I have my Linux PC up and running. You can see I'm having Linux Mint 20.1. And now we go with the software that will be used to decode the protocol from the keyfob. So the software is Universal Radio Hacker, and it does exactly what it says. So it is for decoding pulses from the radio transmission. How to install it, I will not be showing in the details. I just give you some clues. So first you need to have a GIT installed, then you clone the repository from this page, then you install Python and Python pip, which is the Python module installer. And when you have it done, you go to the terminal and go to the directory when you have where you have downloaded this Universal Radio Hacker tool. And right here you have URH, and then we start this with the Python 3 minepy. And when it starts, you'll see such window. And then we start a new project in which we have we need to put some name, keys 2, for example. Now you have select the frequency and some details. Let's start it like it is, then OK, default gain, and now I have to record the signal. So we go to the record signal option, then I have to press a button on my key, but first I will press the start. Now I'm pressing, that would be all, then stop. We have a sample of a signal, then we have to save it. Let's name it keys 2, for example. Then we have to analyze the signal, so let's now close this window. We have some sample of the signal, so this is something that we need to guess what is the modulation. I will put here ASK, so as you can see it sees some zeros and ones. We can of course press the auto detect parameters, and that would be the best option for you. So now after it is decoded, you go to the analysis window and you press analyze protocol, and you will get the data. So these data are presented as zeros and ones, but you can select some options here. Let's show it like a hex digits. So you can see now the digits that are corresponding to the bits that are transmitted by the key fob. So first is a preamble, and the synchronization preamble. Then there's a I would say the payload. So this payload and synchronization data, we will copy them to my Arduino sketch that will simulate the keyfob, and now as we have it decoded, we can see once again how the signal looks like. So this is the signal. If you move mouse here, it will show you relevant portion of the signal decoded, but what we already have here, so preamble and the main message. These two we have to copy to my Arduino sketch. And now I'm launching the Arduino IDE. I have prepared some program that will allow you to easily replicate such activity. Oh, in my case, this is the code. So as you saw, and there's two messages that we need to send. First is preamble and then the main payload. So first preamble is 6AA. I will now disconnect the RTL SDR dongle. So AA, let's copy it from here. Now I'm doing the copy and I will paste it into the code. So in my code, I have defined a pin that the FS1000A is connected to, the Arduino board pin. So you need to tune it to your own board. Yeah, actually it should be like this, FS1000A data pin. Save it. And now I have a very long function that will send pulses that are corresponding to the hexadecimal digit. So this is a huge function that sends some pulses that are exactly the binary representation of the hex digit. Okay, so we put the first sequence here. So this is the first one, as you saw, the preamble in my case. Then the second sequence, I will copy this sequence from here. Yeah, let's copy what I have. I need to somehow mark this. As you can see, it is long. So it's something like 50 digits, hexadecimal digits. Oh yeah, now I have copied this, Ctrl C. Then I will put this one here. So it is the same, exact the same as previously. And one more thing, you need to find out what is the pulse width in the number of microseconds. So in my case, it was something like, I believe, this. How to find this? Yeah, that's the most difficult stuff. But I can give you some clue. So you simply select a single bit here, like this, and we show you here what is the duration time. So it's 380 in my case. And this value you also need to take into account when you do some calculation for pulse. So for pulse, how the pulse looks like, you need to multiply the length of the symbol or the sample to get actually the value of the duration of the pulse. So I will try to show you how to do it. Let's use calculator. Let's do it like this. So you can see here that you have a 400 samples per symbol. Per symbol means per single pulse. And single pulse duration is 380 microseconds. So when you have a pulse with such value, you have to first calculate how many symbols it would take. So let's Let's do it like this. Let's calculate first how many symbols it would take. So it would take 9.8 symbols in my case, and then we have to multiply this by the length of the symbol, by 380 microseconds, and we get this value, 3723 microseconds. And we put this value into the code. So if you can see my code, I'm first sending this the preamble sequence, which is defined over here. So this is my sequence, the preamble. Then we put the pulse length, so 3723 in my case. Then we send the second sequence, so which is this one, copied from the analysis tab, from here, and it is shown here. And then we need to calculate the second pulse. So in the interpretation tab, you will see that there's a, after this long sequence, there's a big pulse. Big pulse. So big pulse is, we need to calculate to find out what is the length or the duration in the terms of the microseconds. So it will be like this, divided by the length of single symbol, 40 symbols, and then we have to multiply it by symbol duration, which is 380 in my case. So this 15,230. So after second symbol, we need to put this one here. And it is done. And now we have to compile the script, the INO script, and upload it to the Digispark in my case. You may have some other Arduino, but I will use Digispark. Then I will put this here. Okay, and it is uploading. It already uploaded, I believe. I need to scroll down. Okay, it's done. And now we can test if this cloned keyfob works. Okay guys, now testing time, and I have my device here. I have not pressed yet any button, and the target is here. So let's now press the button. It starts in several seconds. And it works! Shit! Okay, guys. So now you see that it works. Oh my god. Thank you very much. Hope you enjoyed my little video. And see you again. Bye bye.